I'm Dr. Sangeeta Kamath, head of the psychology department of Ram Narayan Uriya College and clinical psychologist by profession. Today we are going to discuss something about stress and anxiety amongst adolescents. Some of the common problems that are experienced by the youth today, the adolescents today, is lack of social connectivity. Then they have difficulty in interpersonal relations. Depression, anxiety, addictions. Okay? The addiction may be maybe to anything, maybe certain licit or illicit drugs, or it can even be addictions like, you know, internet addiction and mobile addiction. So, in short, these are some of the problems experienced by the youth of India today. These problems, if you try to look at the core problem or core reason for these problems, can be because of certain biological factors, certain psychological and certain things related to the changes that have been occurring in the society of late. In order to deal with these problems, majorly what adolescents can do, okay, is develop their social connectivity, which is very important, okay, which will help them to reduce their depression, reduce their sadness, reduce their anxiety, reduce the stresses that they have, okay, because being connected to people, it helps them to resolve a lot of problems. It also brings about a lot of coping mechanisms, positive coping mechanisms. It builds the individual's frustration tolerance, because when you look at others, you realize that not only you have problem, but many others also have the same kind of problem. It also helps them to understand their own strengths as well as weaknesses, and to handle problems even if they have certain weaknesses, even if there are certain setbacks. Okay, because a lot of learning takes place during the adolescence through imitation, that is by seeing others. So when they see certain positive coping mechanisms in others, it also builds their own coping mechanisms. Okay, they also learn how to solve the problems in life. They understand that, you know, it is very important for them to realize that not everything that they want and what they deserve and what they want or like will always be obtained. There would be times when in a lot of efforts, but still you may not get whatever you deserve or whatever you need or whatever you like. Okay, understanding this, accepting this, and moving ahead in life despite all these frustrations and despite all these barriers is what will help people or adolescents today to deal with the frustrations and stresses in their life. Okay? Primarily, stress cannot be something which can be deleted completely out of our life. Every individual may have certain areas of their life where they will experience stress, certain periods in their life when they will experience stress. Completely stress-free life is neither possible nor is it desirable. All these things an adolescent will learn to appreciate and admire and accept only when they learn to live with others. Okay? Understanding your own strengths, understanding your own goals, okay, will also help them to have a very optimistic kind of a perception of life, where there would be certain barriers, there would be certain drawbacks, there would be failures, but despite all these things, there will be something which will keep them going. So these are some of the things that an adolescent can do in order to deal with the anxiety of their present life. Equally important is for them to take care of their diet, okay, because diet and stress, the reactions to stress is very much connected or strongly connected to their diet. Okay, having a proper diet, okay, which is balanced, will help them to take care of their weight, which many a times becomes a frustrating event for an adolescent. So proper weight management, where you don't starve but you take care of all your dietary requirement, which is important to have a proper weight control, which is also key to many health problems. Many diseases can be avoided, which is one of the causes of stress amongst adolescents. Plus, it also helps to keep your brain stimulated to the sufficient extent. Okay? So, taking care of the weight, taking care of the diet and nutrition is very important. Because finally, when you cope up with stress, your coping strategies are all devised mentally, and brain is the seat of all these mental activities. So when the brain is deprived of its proper nutrition requirement, it cannot help you to support in the coping mechanisms. So it is very important to take care of the diet, take care of your aapke habits, because certain habits like alcoholism and drug addiction can not only be a reaction to the stress, but they can also be another factor which can again build up your stresses in life. Okay, because in order to support the right or wrong habits, people will get into a lot of negative behavior, which can become stressful not only to themselves but also to people in their surrounding. Okay, so these are some very simple things that people can take care. Now, despite of taking care of all these things, it's not necessary that the person will not suffer from any mental health problems. Okay, everybody will not require to go to a psychologist. You can learn to deal with your own problems as an adolescent, because it is a transitional phase. There would be certain challenges, but along with the challenges, there are certain opportunities also. Okay, so when you deal with others, when you interact with others, that will help people or an adolescent to devise their own problem solving strategies. But if these fail, and if an adolescent is not able to cope up with the problem, then it is necessary to go and talk to a psychologist. Going to a psychologist need not definitely mean that, you know, there is something wrong and you are mentally unstable. It does not mean that, you know, you are insane. Okay, but you are not able to handle certain problems on your own. The psychologist will help you to understand your own self, understand your own goal, and help you to develop an insight into what is the barrier. And once that barrier is taken care of, then the adolescent is able to move ahead in life without further requirement to be dependent on a psychologist. So once going to a psychologist does not mean that you are totally dependent on an external factor to deal with your own problems. So these myths have to be reduced, because these are the myths that make an individual develop a stigma, okay, towards going to a psychologist. Okay? Even intelligent people, so-called intelligent people, every individual has intelligence, but it is generally felt that, okay, people who have high intelligence or people who are, you know, having even normal intelligence, they need not go to a psychologist. Now these myths will prevent you from going to a psychologist, which will then just make the individual get pent up with their emotions, not being able to handle it, not being able to cope up with it, coping up with minimum amount of resources that they have, and then land up with major problems. So if at all it is not possible for you to solve your problem, there is no reason why one should not go to a psychologist. Now where will you find a psychologist? Okay. You can go to any general government medical hospital, you will find a psychologist. These days, most of the institutions, most of the educational institutions too have psychologists, okay, who will help you to deal with the problem. Okay? So going to a psychologist, okay, should also be one of the measures that you resort to if you are not able to handle the problems. Okay? Because these problems sometimes may just be one of the symptoms of a major illness. Okay? Every time an individual is anxious or depressed does not mean that it has to be just because of certain daily hazards or daily minor problems which are the result of your surrounding. Many a times it can be a symptom of certain major mental illness as well. So if you are not able to handle depression and anxiety or sadness or any of the symptoms on your own, better to go to a psychologist. Okay, because going to a psychologist does not mean that once you go you are totally insane. Okay? There are three different ways in which a psychologist will help you to deal with it. If there is a problem, they will help you for treatment. If there is no problem, they will help you to prevent it in case it is a symptom of a possible illness. Thirdly, they will also help you to preserve your mental health. That is, you may not be insane today, nor do you have high chances of developing any mental illness. But to preserve our mental health is also equally challenging. So they can help you to develop those coping strategies which will help you to develop a preservation of your own mental health. Okay? So it is very easy to take care of the mental health problems. Okay? Try on your own. Okay? Nothing wrong even if you go wrong, because there isn't just one method of dealing with problem. There are multiple ways in which you can handle one problem. Different people may have different strategies to deal with their own problem. So try to analyze your own self, try to understand your own ways of solving problem, try to even explore what are the ways in which you solve your problem. Life will have a lot of challenges. Each of the challenge can be dealt with by every individual in a different way. So understand your own ways, try to challenge your own self. Okay, it is okay if you are a failure. Once a failure does not mean that it is always likely to lead to failures. Okay, you cannot handle in one way, change your way. Try to talk to others who will give you a better way of dealing with their problem. If not, then please go to a psychologist. Nothing wrong with that. Okay. Finally, a good mental health, okay, will help you to have a